Hi, this is Tom from Raymond Osman, and this is a quick tutorial on controlling split lines and tangency in NPower power surfacing and SolidWorks. So we have a power body that I've already created. This is just some kind of handle, just a mock-up for this tutorial. Now, what we want to do is try to control a split line down the side of it. Now, this is roughly put in the power body, but in reality, we'll have some mold tooling or something that will be trying to create this, and we want to lock that split line to that tooling and have precise control over it. So this is how we go about doing it. Now, the first thing we need to do after creating this draft of the power body is to actually create the split surface geometry. So I'll select the right plane here and just go normal to that. So we're looking directly across it. Now, the line of draw isn't quite vertical in this, it's off to the side here, but that doesn't really matter. So we can add a sketch. I'm just going to add a sketch on that right hand plane and select a style spline for this one. I thought I'd do a difficult split surface just to show you how you can do it, but you can also do this with normal lines or arcs. So there's a lot of control that you can achieve this way. So I'm going to put in this style spline. Just roughly follow this line down. And now quickly tune it to match roughly where we've put this draft curve. Now, this style spline, well, we can either make it match it or just make it kind of close. Now, in reality, we'd turn on curvature cones and constrain all these points just to make sure that it's perfect. But for now, I think that's good enough, so I'm just going to accept that and move on with the tutorial. So what we want to do is just extrude that surface out, and I'll set that to a mid-plane so it goes both directions, and just give it a bit of length there. Okay, so this is going to be our split surface. So, if we go to edit the power body is above the split surface in the tree, so you won't be able to see the split surface. But because this split surface isn't referencing the power body, we can just drag that up. Put it above it. Then when we go to edit the power body, we can still see that surface in here. You can just see this purple line here. I've set the split line to 100 in the weighting, just to give a nice sharp line. So what we need to do is we need to tell power surfacing that it can look at this surface. It isn't just a piece of dumb data. So in the power surfacing tab, I'm going to select import references. Just import the reference of that face. So this is showing the yellow grid pattern of the imported surface and the original SolidWorks geometry underneath. Now, just to make it clearer, we can go into this bit of the tree and then left click on that surface in surface bodies and hide it. What we now want to do is constrain this edge here, this split edge, to the surface. So I'm going to put on edge loop selection and select that edge and just check that that's gone all the way around, so you can see the blue highlighted line has gone all the way around. Then back up into the ribbon and constrain that to a face. Now this snaps to the nearest face, and you can have multiple surfaces in here, in which case you're not quite sure which one it's going to snap to, and it snaps to the nearest one. But if it goes wrong, you can always just drag it across and it'll snap to the next one. So I'm going to constrain that to the face, and it looks awful. I've got this weird edge going all the way around it, and it's pulled across the end here, and it looks really bad. But we can fix this. So what it's done is it's defaulted to being tangent to the surface, which is great if you're trying to blend to existing SolidWorks surfaces. But if you're trying to use the SolidWorks surface to control a split line like this, it just isn't a good result. So we'll switch to face ring selection, and we'll grab those faces there. Now, just checking at the end, it hasn't got all of them in that face ring. So hold down Control and select those faces. Back up to the ribbon, and we're going to go to this button, which is Override Tangency. So it's defaulted to making it tangent to the constraint geometry. And so that's what we're seeing there. Now, we've got two controls. We've got one on controlling the strength of it, so we can change how far the tangency progresses into the part. And we also have one controlling the angle. So if you really need to control precise angles from that surface, you've got control of that here as well. And you can alter both of them. Another option is to make it perpendicular, so we can select that. And that's set it perpendicular straight to that face, which is going to be useful in some situations. However, for this part, I really'd like a very nice sharp edge split line running down it. So we've got this other option here of nothing. So I'm going to select nothing, and that neither gives you tangency nor the perpendicularity. And that's then controlled off where you have all the other geometry. So this is a bit more manual, but you have a bit more control over exactly what shape you get. Now, the angle is not doing anything here, so you can change that and nothing's going to happen. But you've still got some control with this strength. So we can dial that up and we can dial it down again. I find it quite useful to set it to zero so that you get a sharp edge. So I'm going to select that and accept it, but it still looks weird. We've still got this edge underneath. So that's because this other edge is still trying to be tangent to this face. Now, I could have selected all these faces at the same time, but I just wanted to demonstrate that. So grab that, and again, the extra faces that haven't been caught up, and we'll go back to Override Tangency, set that to nothing, and set the strength to zero. Now what we have is we have this split line back, and now that is precisely following the curve that we had inputted into SolidWorks. Now if you update the curve in SolidWorks, there's a button here called Update Constraints, and that will refresh where that curve is and resnap those points to it. I'm just going to look around the part, and you can see here it's pulled it out a bit. So I'm going to go back into the SolidWorks part of the tree, and I've got a line of draw plane here. So I'm going to select that and just select normal to that, so I can see right down the top of the part. Back into Power Surfacing, select the points and select normal to the screen, so I can adjust just in this direction. So I'm adjusting these points, and these points are actually moving on the imported geometry. So you move it, and then it does a little bit of maths and calculates exactly where it should be. So there's a little bit of a lag sometimes with some of these points, but I'm just going to pull these out till it looks about right. Yep, I think that's going to do. So if we accept that and let it rebuild our surface split line, when I show that again, is now perfectly lined up with the power body.